We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. Tonight, we've got a good matchup in store between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Houston Astros. And that'll bring in Yandy Diaz. And we are set for baseball here this evening. This will miss as well, so he's in danger of losing the leadoff man here tonight. It's 3-1 now. Hit down the line, and that is off the first base bag. And that finds its way through for a base hit. And they won't get an out from this as he's able to reach on a play that you just don't see very often. Into the box now, Brandon Lau. Clearly off with his timing on that one, a swinging strike.
Hey, that two-seam fastball is going to be the be-all, end-all of this game right here. Who's going to execute? Is the pitcher going to be able to keep going to that well, or is the offense going to be able to make an adjustment and hit that ball in the gap?
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch-out. Brandon Lau becomes the first out of the inning. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. At the plate now, Austin Meadows, fouled away. And this is on the ground as short, could be two. One there, over to Gurriel for an inning-ending double play. So coming to the plate, George Springer. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out. Next up for the Astros, Alex Bregman. 1-1. Is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Now you can tell right there that curveball had some serious depth to it. That's what separates the good ones from the bad ones. That nasty spin rate, get that downward action. You even get a star player like this swinging at something in the dirt.
And he fouls this one off. Another 1-2 delivery. Just a bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. Now a curveball's in there, 1-2 now.
I know it's the first inning, but he better find his release point on that breaking stuff, or he's in for a long day.
But a good play by the first baseman to spear this one, and that'll retire the side. Second inning set to go, and digging in is the rookie designated hitter, Yoshitsu Tsugo. 1-2, here it comes. Ball. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball in that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Yoshitsu Tsugo becomes the first out of the inning. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now.
As a veteran out on the mound, that's a pitch that you expect to get a call on. Got to believe he keeps pounding that spot until he builds a rapport with the umpire.
Throw on to first is in time, and Grinke's got himself two outs. Up next for the Rays, Kevin Kiermaier. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. And it's fouled away. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Left side, but well fouled. This is pulled into right. Reddick will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Last half of the second set to go, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Yuli Gurriel. 1-1. Down the left field line and deep, and this will wind up a foul ball. All even at 2-2. Here it is.
Well, I think that pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it, but it just ended up taking off on him.
Good battle. Count remains full. The next 3-2. Oh, he finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat. So one away here with the bases empty. And in to hit next will be the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. 2-2. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. Adames picks it up. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close. So bases are empty here with two gone. And the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Astros shortstop in front with a 3-1 count.
Three ball count right now. This looks like the best chance of getting a base runner on so far.
Had a good 3-1 cut, but he misses the splitter. 3-2 now. Now a curve ball in there. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Top of the third set to get underway. And digging in is the outfielder, Manuel Margot. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Tucker comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Squared that one up just a little late. Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third.
The first baseman, number two.
Stepping into the box, Yandy Diaz. A base hit in his first trip. Soft grounder left side. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. So striding forward now, Brandon Lau. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Line towards center field, and that'll get down for a base hit.
First baseman,
In now, Joey Wendell. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
And a little self-preservation down at first as he pulls that one in to end the inning. Striding in for Houston, Josh Reddick, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Now the 2-1. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away. Settling in now, Aledmys Diaz. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Fastball too low, and that's ball four. Coming to the plate now, Martin Maldonado. First shot for him here, with a runner at first now and one away. Throw over to the bag, and the runner back. Astros still have yet to tally their first hit in this one. Fastball taken inside for a ball. 2-1 now. A 2-2 count to the Astros catcher.
Hey, I don't blame him for giving up on that curveball. That was a rainbow coming out of the sky. Stole a strike.
And a swing and a miss, and another punch out here. Six already, and that's out number two. Standing in, George Springer. He went down swinging to start the home first. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. High in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Hit in the air down the right field line. No one can make a play on this one, and the first Astros hit is going to be for extra bases. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double. To the plate now, Alex Bregman. One ball and two strikes to count. And they come inside with the fastball, but it misses here, and it's back to 2-2.
Well, his pitch count has really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Kiermaier is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Austin Meadows.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get them in, but that hasn't been the case.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Yoshitsugo looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out. So digging in now, Willie Adames. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. To two balls and two strikes now. Pops this one up. Gurriel over to his right, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And striding forward, the designated hitter, Michael Brantley. Nope. And this is low, ball two. 2-1. And he lays off again, ball three.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Pulled toward right center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it. One down. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Yuli Gurriel. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
You know, Matty, tough to go down looking right there, especially in a long at bat. I kind of tip my hat to the fact that he didn't go into uber swing mode. He battled. He just got locked up. Look for him to have another quality AB. I think he's seeing the ball pretty darn big right now.
Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time. Is laid off and the count runs full.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
The next 3-2. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4. On pitch number 10 is the one that finally does it as he strikes out after a long battle here. Standing in, Kyle Tucker. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Hit hard back up the middle. Adames brings it in. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring up the versatile center fielder Manuel Margot. The 1-1 home. Skied into straightaway right. Reddick has a read on it. He's got it one away. So the leadoff man set down, and here's the catcher, Mike Zunino. No runs, 3 hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. Down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
And he takes ball 4, so a good job out of the 9-hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. 2-1 to the Rays leadoff batter. Smoke toward the hole, and that gets through for a one out base hit, and that runner will go no further than second as there are 2 aboard now. Stepping in now, Brandon Lau. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Full count now, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. And that misses for ball 4. So the bases are loaded here with one man gone. And digging in next will be Joey Wendell. Here's the 1-1. Down the left field line and deep. Ball that's carrying. But this will land untouched. Zunino, the runner at third. Diaz at second. Lau at first. One gone. Fouled away. The 1-2. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. Gone! It's a grand slam! So now to the plate, Austin Meadows. Swing and a liner. But sadly for him, this will head straight to the center fielder as he puts it away without much trouble for the second out.
Yoshi.
Into the box now, Yoshitsu Tsugo. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch. It's swung on and missed for strike number 2.
He's staring a hat trick in the face right now after that swing. He has just got to find a way to zone up a little bit more.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Bottom of the inning now. And ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa. Now a curveball misses inside.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. And he fouls this one off. Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. And the throw is there to record the first out. So striding in, Josh Reddick. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Line hard. And it's fouled away. Snatched out of midair at first base for out number 2. Ready for another chance? Aledmys Diaz. He drew a walk his first time up. Diaz. 1-1. High and deep to left center field. And that one is gone on a 2-strike count with 2 away in the inning.
Well, they're still down, but this homer right there might light a fire under the whole team. Give them a spark to climb back into this thing. We'll see if this gets them going.
At the plate, Martin Maldonado. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Brad Peacock takes over to start the 6th inning on the mound.
Number 41.
Top half of the 6th about to get started, and up next will be Willie Adames. The 1-2. Is swung on and missed. He got him. So here's Kevin Kiermaier. He was retired after popping out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over.
A full count to the Rays center fielder.
I like what he was trying to do there with the two-seam fastball, but that's a tough pitch to come in. When you throw it glove side like that, it's really tough to get it to come back to the corner.
And he takes ball 4, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here. Here's a look over to first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. The 3-1 pitch. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with 2 strikes. The 3-2 pitch. Fouled off. Fouled away. Another payoff pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Reddick has a read on it, and that's the 2nd out of the inning. Digging in, Mike Zunino. Sixth inning. 4-1 is our score. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front. Working for the punch out and the offering. Hit high and deep out to left center field. Ranging back is Tucker. A leap, but he can't get it. It's off the wall. They'll extend their lead here as the runner scores from first. Make it 5-1.
The first baseman, number 2, Yandy.
At the plate now, Yandy Diaz. Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now 3-1. And that misses ball 4, so it's first and second now with 2 out. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Brandon Lau. He's 1-for-2 in this one. And he fouls this one off. Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. Sent on the ground out to second. He'll go to Correa for the force, and that ends the inning. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and coming forward, the veteran outfielder, George Springer. The 1-2. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Scooped up. And the throw to first is in time. One gone. One away for the Astros here in the sixth. And that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Sent on the ground, but right into the shift. A dive, but he can't knock it down. It's through for a base hit. Into the box now, Michael Brantley. On the ground to second base. This could be 2. To second for 1. On to first, it's a double play. As their woes continue, the inning is over. C.N.L. Pérez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 52.
Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Joey Wendell.
Hey, the difference in this one, they lead by 4. Go back to this guy's previous AB, a towering grand slam that knocked in 4 runs.
And this is into the gap for his 3rd hit of the night, and it'll be good for extra bases. And he is in to second with a double, his 3rd hit of the night.
The right fielder, Austin Meadows.
In now, Austin Meadows. And he'll back him off a bit with a fastball in, but it's 3-1 now.
Not a good spot to be in right now. A pitch has fallen behind in the count with a guy up that hits really well with runners in scoring position.
And a fastball misses there. Ball 4.
The designated hitter, Yoki Tsukugo.
Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. Pérez. A Cuban-born ball player. This is his 2nd year as a major leaguer. Now the 2-1. Now both runners on the move. He swings and misses. Throw down. And they will get the lead runner at 3rd. A daring attempt with no outs on the scoreboard, and it doesn't pan out. Ready with the 2-2. And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. 4 strikeouts. Now batting, Willie Adames. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. And that misses ball 4, so it's 1st and 2nd now with 2 out. Striding in, Kevin Kiermaier. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. And it's fouled away. Here's another 1-2. started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone. So here's the cleanup hitter, Yuli Gurriel. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
Grounder down the line at third. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. Ready now, Kyle Tucker. No hits to this point. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Bounce to the right into the loaded up infield. Fielded cleanly. And the off-balance throw beats him at first. And that's a tough play. So next to swing the bat will be Carlos Correa. He's hoping to avoid the hat trick. He struck out in each of his first two plate appearances so far. Correa in front, 3 balls and a strike.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
Seared down the first baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Grounded back up the middle, and that'll get by into center field for a base hit. Chaz Rowe takes over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning. Into the box, Josh Reddick. High and wide, 2 balls and a strike. Nope. 3-1 now. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. Back goes Kiermaier to the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Andre Scrub has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Ready to begin the eighth, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Manuel Margot. The 1-1.
Whoa, that's down.
To 2-2 now.
2-2.
And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt him over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? It's a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
Well, the 1-2 pitch didn't go his way, and now a miss there on 2-2.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one, without a doubt, is gone.
Love that approach right there, and we're seeing that a lot more in today's game. Guys having the ability to just be strong enough to drive the ball out to all parts of the field.
Stepping in now, Yandy Diaz. Line drive to center field. But this is unfortunately right at him in center field as he takes it in for the first out. Into the box, Brandon Lau. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now. pulled toward right center field. Springer has a read on it. He's got it, and there are two down now. Digging in and looking for more, Joey Wendell. He went deep back in the fifth. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he popped him up. Bregman in foul ground. But this will land untouched. The 1-2. 7 runs, 8 hits. And no errors for Tampa Bay so far. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Well hit to right, but that's a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Softly hit out towards short. And the off-balance throw will be too late, so a good effort that time, but it's an infield single. Cy Snead comes on the pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. Standing in now, Austin Meadows, 2-1. Two and two.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel to that one.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And it's a foul ball. And another foul ball. Making him sweat out there. The 7th pitch coming up. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. At the plate, Aledmys Diaz.
Hey, in the last at-bat when he hit that home run on an off-speed pitch, he didn't really crush it, but he certainly hit it well enough to drive it out of the ballpark.
They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2. Rowe was known as a short relief specialist, a guy who came in, got 1 or 2 big outs, but with the new pace of play rules, they're forcing a change for this right-hander. Full count, 3-2. And the payoff pitch. High and deep to left center field. Margot's going back. But he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. He hit the corner and tries for third. And he'll get there as he legs out the leadoff triple. At the plate now, Martin Maldonado. And that misses 2-1. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1.
That's a close pitch right there, but I think he's just nibbling a little bit too much. Out of the pen sometimes, you just have to come in and go right after guys.
And the count will be full. Now the 3-2 pitch. Fouled off. Payoff pitch one more time, and he takes ball 4. So a good job out of the 9-hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. So the Houston lineup turns over, and to the plate, George Springer. Lifetime against this pitcher. He's a 333 hitter. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
2-2 now. Hit to first. He's got it. To second for one. on to first, and it's a double play, although the run does come into score for the third. Colin Poche enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning. Digging in, Alex Bregman. He singled his last time up. Ball and two strikes now.
You got to be paying attention as an offense in a hitter's meeting in this situation. When you got a guy on the mound that you know the bottom can drop out of any pitch he throws, you have to elevate your sights.
Liner in there for a base hit.
The batter, the designated hitter, Michael.
So now to the plate, Michael Brantley. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it, and that ends the inning. New inning set to get underway, and standing in is the DH, Yoshitsu Tsugo. Two balls and a strike. Fouled away. Popped him up. Bregman has room in foul territory, and that's the first out of the inning. Now with the play, Willy Adames. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Here's the pitch. Now a ball lying toward the gap in left center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Now that the center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
At the plate, Kevin Kiermaier. And it's a ball and two strikes to Kiermaier now. Line towards center field. That's in there. Base hit. Now a long throw to third. And he is in there.
Now batting. The left fielder. And
to the plate now, Manuel Margot. Now a little pop-up off toward the first base side. Gurriel is over now, and he's got it for out number two. So here's Mike Zunino, and they're runners at the corners now.
And that last at-bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball, so I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter, so I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out and try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
A one and two count to the Rays catcher. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. He'll try again, 1-2. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. The 2-2 one more time. He is swung on and missed, strike three. Diego Castillo, the right-handed reliever standing 6-3, gets the ball now out of the bullpen.
Diego.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And here comes the first baseman, Yuli Gurriel. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Gurriel swings, and it's hit very well out to left. Margot looks up. It's up and out of here into the archway.
Hey, you just got to tip your hat if you're on the mound. For him to have the ability to keep that pitch fair, that's a breaking ball on the inner half. How many times have we seen that one hook foul?
Stepping in now, Kyle Tucker. And it's two balls and two strikes now. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Margot's on the move. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. Here's Carlos Correa now. One run in and one gun so far in this inning. The 1-1 home.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
Line to the right side. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball. Fly ball out toward left center field. Margot's under it, and he makes the catch for the second out. Now at the plate, Josh Reddick. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. Hit down the third baseline. Scooped up. Throw on to first will be in time, and the Rays have taken home field advantage right from the start. They claim game one on the road as this one is over.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awfully hard to win in this game, especially on the road. But they find a way to get it done, and they should be very happy with this performance.
Well, heroes are made in the postseason, and he was at least the hero in this one. He's our Topps player of the game.
And obviously, every game is so important in the postseason. So when you come to play like he did and make a big difference for your team, it's something that won't be forgotten.
And tonight's final, 7-3. The Tampa Bay Rays win the opener here in the division series. Charlie Morton pitches well enough to get the W. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
The final line score for our ball game tonight, for the victorious Rays, 7 runs, 11 hits, no errors, they left 12 men on base. For the Astros, 3 runs on 7 hits, 1 error, they left 5 men on base.